in a later age.
Yeah.
Thus he asks for a double portion.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because it's more dangerous to be young.
Yeah.
More challenging to live right.
Uh-huh.
More taxing to balance your bank book.
Yeah.
More treacherous to be an entrepreneur.
Yeah.
More complicated to invest wisely. More demanding to be a preacher.
Yeah.
It's stressful to be a parent. You gotta be diligent to be a deacon. You gotta be committed to be a pastor.
Yeah. Yeah.
Therefore, you need to have a double portion.
Yeah.
You're not gonna get by with a single portion.
Well,
you need God to give you a double portion.
Yeah.
Our prayer tonight ought to be like Elijah. Lord, give me a double portion.
Yeah.
Elijah said, give me, I pray. Said, they are at Gilgal. Elijah said, I've got to go now. But I cannot stay here.
Well,
I'm going to Bethel.
Yeah.
But Elijah said, as the Lord lives. Elijah said, I cannot stay here. I've got to go to Bethel.
Well,
and when they came to Bethel, the two of them together, the students of the school of came out from the schoolhouse. And they greeted their master teacher, Elijah. Elijah said to Elijah, don't you know the Lord's going to take your teacher away from you?
Well,
the young Elijah went and told the young students, I know, let the Lord direct the transition.
Well,
the young man spoke up and said, it will not happen here.
Yeah.
But I cannot stay here. Yeah. So Elijah said, you stay here with the rest of my students.
My
and let me go on to Jericho.
Yeah.
You cannot go where I am going. But Elijah said again, as you live, and as I live, I will not leave you.
Yeah.
So they went together until they came to Jericho. And again, the students came to discourage Elijah.
Yeah.
And told him that you got to go home. But he told them again, shut up.
Yeah.
Let God do the direct. Elijah said, I got to go down to the Jordan River. But there was no school of prophets there. The young prophets began to hide behind the trees and behind the rocks of Jericho.
Yeah.
As they were looking down on the Jordan. Isn't it interesting, my brothers and my sisters, how people will come to discourage you rather than come to encourage you.
Yeah.
And but preacher, I want you to be reminded that every day won't be like this day.
Yeah.
Some of the same people that's talking positive unfortunately, they want to flip to the other side.
Yeah.
Some of the people who pray pastor today are going to change and be against the pastor eventually. But don't you worry about it, because you see that the Lord will be by your side.
Yeah.
Don't you ever worry, because he said, hey, I'll be with you, even until the end of the world. No matter the wind may blow, storms may rise. But don't you worry about it. God said he will be with you.
Amen.
And when they went down to the Jordan, when they got there, Elijah said, what should I do? The water is deep.
Yeah.
And we don't even have a boat to get over.
Well,
there's no bridge for us to get across. But Elijah said, I got power in my hand.
Yeah.
He pulled off his mantle, struck the water, and the river opened up.
Yeah.
And just then, the two of them walked together through the Jordan. Isn't it beautiful what you can do when you got somebody walking with you?
Yeah.
You can walk together in trouble, in the spirit of God, and get to the other side. You can get through stuff. When you got somebody walking with you, you can get through death and darkness. When you got somebody walking racism, when you just got somebody walking together with you to get to the other side. Well, when they came to the other side, Elijah said, I've got to go now. But I tell you, what do you want me to do? The young man said, oh, my teacher, I pray that you let a double portion of the Spirit of God fall down on me. And I noticed what the old man said. He said, if you see me, in other words, if you stay around me, if you study me, you know how to worry. Don't think the new way is always the best way. Find an old seasoned who know how to deal with folks, who know how to get on his knees and call on the name of your battles. And just learn to be still. And know He is God. He said, just watch me. Just then a chariot of fire came from nowhere and stood between the old man and the young man. The old man disappeared as Elijah was watching. And as the mantle fell from the young man, fell down to his feet. Young Elijah picked up the mantle. He was wondering, did he have it? Did he see enough? And then he spoke and he hit the water with the mouth. And then the waters opened up again. And when it got to the other side, the prophets came from behind the trees, behind the rocks. And when they saw the young man, they said, the same spirit that was on Elijah, the same spirit that's on Elijah. Say, Brother Robert said, when they see you and when they see me, I want them to say the same spirit that got black death through slavery, the same spirit that created the black church, the same spirit that dealt with racism. Our people wrote spirituals rather than dictionary. I want them to say that same spirit as they go through this. You don't need just one portion. You need another portion. You need the Spirit of God. A single portion won't see you through. The first portion will put you in church. But the second portion will put the church in you. The first portion will say you're saved by grace. The second portion will sanctify you by the Holy Spirit. The first portion will say, thy will be done. The second portion will say, Lord, do something with me. The first portion will make you hang around the church and ask God to give you something. But the second portion will make you ask God to do something with you. The first portion will make you ask